alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters and dear friends. Welcome to Salam Corner. 2 weeks ago, we did a social experiment where we were talking to atheists, and we had Sister Kiara.
Yes.
Sorry, I'm bad with names. Sister Kiara came, and she was just interested. She watched some of our videos. We had a discussion. You can watch that video. I saw her yesterday.
Yeah.
Same place, because we did another social experiment. And she came, and she said she's going to come here today. And obviously I was waiting for her to come. She had some questions. We answered some of them off camera. There was one question that you wanted to ask regarding polygamy.
Yeah.
And yeah, what was the question?
Is it only for men or are women allowed to do that? And okay. Where did the idea come from?
Okay, so the polygamy is only for men. And I'll explain to you why. These days we have DNA. Back in the days, for example, if a woman had four husbands, and firstly we say it's not in a woman's nature to want or desire multiple partners. Women tend to be hypergamous. Men tend to be polygamous. So, for example, if a woman had four husbands and she had sexual intimacy with all of them, how would you know who the father is? How would we know who the father is? If she has intimacy with four husbands, and how are we going to know who the dad was? So back in the days, imagine, yeah? So now we have a technology, okay. But back in those days, you didn't know. Number two, having more kids. If a man has four wives, and he has intimacy with all of his wives, you know who the father is, you know who the mother is. Yeah? That's one wisdom. And also, for those nations, for example, you would get attacked from different tribes. So to build a nation, you need to have a lot of kids. Yeah? So that's another wisdom behind it. Another wisdom behind it is that a lot of times, men tend to die. Even in today's time. Be it being murdered, be it, for example, ended up in prison. There's a lot of factors in place which men die younger than women. So these women are left with no partners. And Islam believes that everyone deserves a life partner. So if this means that a woman has to share a husband, let it be. You know? So that's one wisdom. Polygamy in today's time, this is a Kiara, is I think it's needed. In today's time, let me tell you why. Because you have a lot of people who are not Muslim. Do you want to say the drink?
Oh, no, thanks.
Okay, there's a cafe there, we'll go get it off. Yeah? So now, I believe polygamy is needed in today's time. You know why? Polygamy is not a Muslim issue. Every man is polygamous. Bring me any man to come here, look at my eyes and say to me I'm not polygamous. He's a liar. So, what do? They have side chicks, they have mistresses, they have girlfriends. What Islam says is, hold on a second. If you are going to, and side chicks, girlfriends, and mistresses are what? You have a wife, and you have these girls on the side that you use and abuse. Now, Islam says that is wrong. And they give me a sentence, defend the right of the woman. How? You're going to think, hold on a second. Women hate polygamy. How can polygamy be sent to protect women? Let me tell you how. Allah says in the Quran, if you are going to get married, or if you desire or want to marry again, you cannot go and abuse another woman. You cannot go and abuse another woman. How? A poor wife, I'm going to go and get a side chick, I'm going to visit every now and then, and when I'm bored of her, get lost. Sam says no. Because if you look at this relationship, it's hidden, nobody wants to know. The guy who's doing it with the mistress doesn't speak to the family, he doesn't announce it, he's using her for one thing. Islam says no. You want to get married again? You want another woman in your life? You have to go and speak to the father, number one. So when I'm speaking to the father and the brother, I know there's going to be consequences if things go wrong, right? So if I'm having the intention to only have intimacy, I know that if I leave her dad and brother are going to be on my case, number one. Number two, you have to give a mahar. You know what mahar is? Dowry. So if a brother wants to marry you, when you become a Muslim, inshallah, now, inshallah, if he wants to marry you, you have a right to ask for anything. £1 million. If he's broke, he won't be married, yeah?
Right.
The thing is, that's your right. You can say, I want a ring, a diamond ring. Make sure you ask for this, by the way. Ask for a diamond ring, gold, £3,000, whatever you want, a car, a holiday, that's your right. So as a woman, you ask that. And you know why that's good? Because if a man has bad intentions, why would he want to give you £2,000? So it's there, look, the family, coming to your family is to protect you as your right. You're asking for mahar, he's thinking, Rabab, I only want one thing. Why would I pay £5,000? One that, it protects you. Number three, you have to announce it. So if brother, let's say Adam is marrying Kiara, you have to let people know we got married. He has to look after you and provide for you. So do you see why polygamy is in place? So that it stops the abuse of men who might have status, who might have wealth, to abuse other women. It's there just to regulate and do things the right way instead of using women and abusing them.
That makes sense.
Does it make sense?
Yeah, it does. Thank you.
Okay, right. So you said, Sister Khaira, that you wanted to accept this stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah? Did I force you?
No.
Did I say if you don't, there will be troubles? Did you come here? Did I tell you to come here?
No.
Okay. What is the reason you want to accept Islam, in a nutshell?
I've always felt a deeper connection to Islam and more drawn to it.
You felt a deeper connection?
Yeah, and I don't really believe in the teachings of Christianity, and I've kind of strayed away from it, and I've educated myself in Islam, and I felt like...
Okay, it's, I would say it's an honor. If you want to do it with me, you want to do it with your friend, or...?
I can do it with you.
Okay, it's yours, right? It's an honor. And before we do it, I just want to give a little reminder. It's very important, brothers and sisters, to understand that Allah guides. We are just people who just, Allah chooses that people see our videos or whatever it may be. So we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't see the shahadas as trophies, like, oh, I'm so special, look at me. So let's bear that in mind, inshallah, just a general reminder. You can repeat after me, yeah?
Ashadu.
Ashadu.
Allah.
Allah.
إلها
إلها
إلا الله
إلا الله
وأشهد
وأشهد
أن
أن
محمدا
محمدا
رسول الله
رسول الله.
I bear witness there is nothing worthy of worship,
there is nothing worthy of worship
except Allah and Prophet Muhammad is his final messenger. Takbir.
Okay. Thank you.
Amazing.
You can hug her too.
Thank you.
May Allah bless you. I just want to give you. I think that sister wants to hug you. Sister. Yes. No. I think that sister wants to hug you.
Sorry, I didn't even want to go.
No problem. Okay,
you.
So one thing that I want to say, Sister Khaira, because as a revert myself, as a revert myself, I want to give you some advice. Yeah. So, firstly, how's your parent? How would your mom and dad like? Are they? Would they be okay? Okay. Who are you more close to?
My dad.
Your dad.
Yeah.
Okay. Look, your parents love you, they want the best for you, but obviously they might obviously think that Islam is some kind of a, you know, dangerous belief, yeah? So what I want you to do, what I want you to do is the best form, because I believe people who come to Islam, you're like a chosen ambassador of God. You might be the reason your family members come to Islam, yeah? So I would say the best form of dawah you can give them is your actions. The way you carry yourself. You're a Muslim now, alhamdulillah, and you would obviously have to be an example, yeah? You're gonna have your ups and downs. I have my ups and downs sometimes, you know. I would say be careful to joining groups. There are people there, then they look out and sadly they hunt for new reverts, yeah? Especially Muslim girls, new reverts, yeah? Anything to do with marriage, yeah, I'm not saying you are, but I'm just saying, anyone, make sure you have a wali. A wali is like your guardian. Yeah? Somebody that looks out for you, yeah? I don't know if you have any... There we go. You're saying there, yeah, no problem. The wali has to be a male, but it's good if you have to make sure. Do you get it? Because what it is that you can be taken advantage of. Do not, if you join any group that has this notion of, oh, don't listen to him, don't listen to that, then this guy, stay the hell away from that. They will ruin your life. Stay away. Be careful, and also, step by step, get closer to Islam. There is a retreat happening with Ayra. I don't know if you heard of Ayra.
Oh, I saw it in a story. Yeah.
It's for reverts.
Okay.
I think it's men and women. So these are all new Muslims. They're going on a retreat and they will learn how to pray, and it happens absolutely free. You're in contact with Instagram.
Yeah.
Okay. I can arrange that if you want to. It's totally up to you. Learn how to pray. Start learning about Allah, who Allah is, his attributes. Read the Seal of Nectar.
Oh, yeah.
The Seal of Nectar. see if you can get the book called The Sealed Nectar. Yeah, it's very good. It's the story of the Prophet, peace be upon him. And start praying and pray to God for your guidance, to keep you firm. And yeah, do you have any questions?
No, that's it. Yeah.
Okay, no problem.
Thank you so much.
No problem. Allah bless you, inshallah, and keep you firm. If you have any questions, if you have any worries, I'm here every Sunday. Come talk. I can get you in contact with the sisters. If you want to learn how to pray, maybe the sister can help you, inshallah. And may Allah bless you, inshallah.
Thank you.
May Allah bless you guys, inshallah. If you want, I can get coffee. You want drink, anything? No problem. May Allah bless you, take care. Take care and help yourself. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi. So, brothers and sisters, we had a shahada today. And to be honest, like I said, brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, Sister Kiara was very interested in Islam for the past, I think, couple of months. And she said she is still looking into it. I did not know that she would be taking a shahada today. And subhanAllah, I knew she was coming today. And I did make a dua, said, oh Allah, ease her heart, inshallah. Because she did say she needs more time to look in, 3-4 months, etc. Yeah. And yeah, anyways, so brothers and sisters, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept it from her and us. And yeah, from salam to next time, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.